So mixed with all the negative news we hear constantly that we're inundated with, especially when it comes to cities like Newark, Newark in particular, with the crisis of the poison water and the lack of direction from politicians and the just leaving so many people out in the cold with so many questions, you know, right up to all these hotshot celebrities parading through during the Video Music Awards and using that platform to attack the president and not make a mention of the hundreds of people that were protesting outside because all they want is clean water for their kids. Well, there's some positive stuff going on in Newark, and typically these things happen because of local people who have suffered themselves, who just want to give back. And there's one organization that is a youth mentoring program for girls who are 6 to 13, and they are celebrating their 10th anniversary. They've got their a walk coming up on Sunday, September 15th, and I wanted to introduce you to the woman behind this. It's called Girls Live, Love, and Laugh. Her name is Allison James-Frison, and she joins me now. Good morning, Allison. How are you?
Good morning, Bill. I'm doing well, and thank you for having me on your show.
Well, I appreciate you coming on, Allison. We talk about so many bad things going on in this state, and Newark in particular seems to get beat up constantly, and they can't get out of their own way with the politicians. And boom, here you are, this rising star amidst all this chaos, doing the right thing to try to help these young girls. Tell me about your group and what you hope to accomplish with these kids.
Now, Girls Live, Love, Laugh, Inc. is a mentor program for girls between ages of 6 to 16 years old. We serve as a beacon of hope for girls that live in the city of Newark with the to empower them to reach their highest and their fullest potential. I established this nonprofit organization because of my background. You know, I was born and raised in the city of Newark, housing authority projects. And growing up in the projects, I learned firsthand what limited resources and education can do to young girls. I am a survivor of child sexual abuse, domestic violence, gun violence, and homelessness. My father, he was killed when I was 17 years old. I lost my self-esteem when my father died. My mom passed away a few years later from a heart attack, and my former fiance was also killed. So all these things happened to me.
My God, Allison, what a story.
Yes, as a young girl and as a young adult. So God actually placed it on my heart to start an establishment like Girls Live, Love, Laugh, Inc. to help girls that are living in low-income communities such as myself.
Allison, how do you do it? You've got this walk now. This is your third annual walk, right? And you're using the hashtag Girls Matter Walk. What are you looking for people to do? To join the walk? Can they give money online and help you?
Yes, we are asking that girls and women from all over to come out and celebrate girl empowerment. Let our young girls know that we're here for them. We applaud them. And we encourage them to move on. We are looking for sponsors, partnerships. They can go on our website, www.girlslivelovelaugh.org, if they want to make a donation. We are asking all participants that are coming to the walk to donate socks, hats, and gloves for the homeless population. We know the winter months are coming, and we want to provide those that do not have an address with some of the tools they need to stay warm this winter.
Wow. Well, I want to applaud you for two things, Allison. One, you really are a great example of how the human spirit can adapt to terrible circumstances and overcome adversity. I mean it, Allison. You're a real inspiration. I'm so glad that Lisa Durden introduced us and asked me to just shine some light on what you're doing. It is, in today's world, so many people just wave that flag of victimhood and say, hey, I'm a victim. Somebody come and help me. And you're saying, okay, there are victims out there. You're one of them, but it's about empowerment. It's about standing up for yourself. And sometimes you need a little help to get up off the ground, but you are certainly doing it for these young women. So I applaud your efforts. Thank you so much. And we'll pray for you and these young girls in Newark that they get the opportunity they deserve.